Class of biology. So we were studying about animal kingdom chapter 4, and in the previous video I have been discussing about some of the criteria that was used to classify the animals. So we have discussed about various criteria like levels of organization. Then we have studied about symmetry and depends upon the layers, okay, the germinal layers like ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderm. The organisms were classified as diploblastic and triploblastic organisms, isn't it? So this much we have studied in the previous video. So today we are going to study about another criteria that is used for classifying the animals, that is coelo. So first we need to know what is coelo. Coelo means cavity only, that is the cavity between the body wall and the gut wall. Okay, so this is the body wall, okay, and this is the gut means what? Alimentary canal. Just imagine our body wall is what, in that skin, muscles, etc. there, and inside that what is there? The alimentary, or in the center we are having the alimentary canal. Just imagine the human beings digestive system. Digestive system is called what? Alimentary canal or gut, GUT, gut. Okay, so in between the space between the gut wall of the gut and the body wall, that is our the external body wall. Okay, so this space is known as what? The coelom. Okay, is it clear? So the cavity between the body wall and the alimentary canal or gut wall is known as what? The coelom. Understood? So just imagine our what, heart, kidney, all these are placed in the cavity, isn't it, which is present where? In between the gut wall and the body wall. All other organs are placed outside the alimentary canal and inside the body wall, isn't it? And in that space there is a cavity. The cavity is called what? Coelom. So based on the what, presence or absence of coelom, the organism, listen carefully, if coelom is present, the organisms are called those organisms which are having the coelom or cavity between the body wall and the gut wall are called coelomates. Okay, coelomates. Is it clear? Examples are what? Annelids, mollusks, okay, and all other. We are also coelomates only. All other organisms, higher organisms like what? Annelids, mollusks, or arthropods, echinoderms, hemichordates, chordates. Okay, so all these are what? Coelomates means higher organisms are coelomates. And if there is no coelom, that kind of organisms are called acoelomates. Okay, so here you can see, here cells are there, isn't it, in between the gut wall and the body wall. Okay, here you can see the cavity is filled with certain cells. There is no cavity. Cavity is not there. Instead, you can see the cells or tissues. So that kind of organisms where you cannot see any cavity, okay, is called acoelomates. Clear? Coelomates and acoelomates are clear to you? Acoelomates means what? The organism without the coelomic cavity. Understood? Examples, platyhelminthes. Understood? Then next you see, coelomates means what? Coelomates are those organisms which are having a cavity. See, here you can see a cavity is there in between the body wall and the gut wall, and you can see that this cavity is lined by mesodermal tissues on both the sides, isn't it? Here also you can see this is the what, this one, this is what, actually mesodermal lining. And here also you can see the mesodermal lining. That is, this cavity is lined by what, mesodermal tissues on both the sides. clear? That kind of coelom is known as what? True coelom. And that kind of organisms are known as coelomates. Clear? Okay. Now, what do you mean by pseudocoelomates then? There is cavity is there. Okay. That is the coelom or cavity is there. But it is not lined by mesoterminal tissues like this. Can you see the red color? Means in red color they have indicated the presence of mesoderm. Okay, so here you can see the cavity is there, white color, that this cavity is there, but it is not lined by mesoderminal tissues on both the sides. But you can see what mesoderm has certain pouches or patches. Okay, certain pouches, you can see the what mesoderm in between the ectoderm and the endoderm. Such a body cavity is called what? Pseudocoelom. Example, ash helminthus. So once again I'll tell you, so another criteria that is used for classification of animals is what? Coelom. Presence of coelom. Coelom means what? The cavity between the body wall and the gut or alimentary canal. Understood? And based on the coelom, the organisms are classified into three types. What are they? Acoelomates, coelomates and pseudocoelomates. Acoelomates means what? In them there is no cavity. Okay, cavity, you cannot see any cavity. They are that space is filled with certain tissues or cells. Clear? So that is known as acoelomates. Now coelomates is what? There is cavity and this cavity is continuously or uniformly lined by mesoderminal tissues. Okay, there is a cavity between the body wall and the alimentary canal and this cavity is uniformly on all the sides. Okay, they are what? Lined by mesoderminal tissues. That kind of organisms are known as what? Coelomates. Okay, now what do you mean by pseudocoelomates? Pseudocoelomates means these organisms are having a cavity but it is not lined by mesoderminal tissues like in coelomates. Okay, it is not continuously lined by mesoderminal tissues, but you can see what? Mesoderminal pouches in the cavity. This is known as what? Pseudocoelomates. Example is what? Ash helminthus. Is it clear? So next is what? Next criteria that is used for classification of animals is segmentation. Segmentation means what? The body is divided into different segments. Okay, with repetition of at least some organs. Understood? So if the body is divided into compartments, several compartments, okay, with the repetition of at least some organs, then it is known as what? Segmentation. Okay, and it is also known as that phenomenon is known as what? Metamerism. The body shows what? The arrangement, the body will have what? Different segments in them with the what? The repetition of some organs at least. That condition is known as segmentation or metamerism. So this you can see in earthworm. Okay, earthworm body is made up of a number of compartments and some organs are repeating also. Okay, so this phenomenon is known as what? Segmentation. If the body is made up of a number of compartments or if the body is divided into number of segments, then it is known as what? Metamerism. Okay, next point that we used to classify, okay, or the next criteria we can say to classify the organism is notochord. Okay, so what do you mean by notochord? Notochord is a rod like, okay, a stick like, rod like structure present in the dorsal side during the embryonic development. Okay, so if the animals are having notochord in their embryonic stage, they are known as what? Chordates. And some are not having this notochord and they are known as non-chordates. So can you see where is our notochord? Notochord is only
later on it is changed into vertebral column, backbone. Understood? So notochord is a rod-like structure that is found during the embryonic development in animals. Okay, so if the notochord is present, okay, in the developmental stage of the organism, then it is known as what? Chordates. And those organisms which are not having what this notochord are known as non-chordates. Okay, so examples for non-chordates are porifera to echinoderms, and chordates are having what? Notochord. Understood? So notochord is what? A dorsal rod-like structure present during the embryonic development. Is it clear?
So these are different phyla that we need to study. That is, first is porifera, cylindrata, tenophora, platyhelminthes, ashelminthes, annelida, arthropoda, mollusca, echinodermata, hemichordata and chordata. This you have studied in your 9th class. Okay, so if you see the different characters, like levels of organization, if you take, only one phylum is having what? Cellular level of organization. What is that? Porifera. Okay, now tissue level of organization and symmetry, if you see radial symmetry, you can see where in cylindrata and tenophora. Okay, now bilateral symmetry you can see from where? From platyhelminthes, ashelminthes, annelids, arthropod, all this are having what? Bilateral symmetry. Okay, now body cavity or coelom, if you see up to platyhelminthes, they are acoelomates. Ashelminthes are pseudocoelomates, and from annelida, arthropoda, mollusca, echinodermata, hemichordata, chordates, all these are with the true coelom. Okay, they are having true coelom. Means you understood now, there is a cavity and this cavity is lined by mesoderminal tissues on both the sides continuously. So once again I will repeat, we were studying about what various criteria that are used for the classification of animals. Okay, so the first one was levels of organization. It includes what? Whether the organisms are having cellular level of organization, tissue level of organization, and organ level of organization, and organ system level of organization. Okay, then I have told you about the digestive system. Okay, two types are there, that is the complete one and the incomplete one. Complete one means if both anus and mouth are there. Understood? And incomplete means if there is only one opening for the ingestion and for the egestion. Okay, then circulatory system, if you see, there are two types, open type and closed type. Then we have to study about the symmetry, means whether the organism can be divided into two equal halves. Okay, so on that basis there are different types of organisms that are asymmetrical, means you cannot cut them into two equal halves through any plane. Radial symmetry means if you are able to divide the organism into two equal halves through any plane that is passing through the central axis. And now next is what? Bilateral symmetry. What do you mean by bilateral symmetry? That is, if the organism can be divided into two equal halves only through a single plane, then it is having bilateral symmetry. Okay, then I have told you about the diploblastic and triploblastic organisms.